of the World Breastfeeding Week from August 1 to 7. Today, I will be speaking about the barriers and contraindications of breastfeeding. The barriers to breastfeeding are inadequate knowledge, embarrassment, social factors, and negative perception towards breastfeeding, lack of support from partner and family, return to work or school, lack of workplace facilities and unsupportive healthcare environment, discomfort about nursing in public, aggressive marketing by formula companies. Contraindications to breastfeeding are if the child has galactosemia or phenylketonuria, if the mother is infected with HIV, or the mother is taking medications such as radioactive isotopes, cancer chemotherapy, or illegal drugs. The following situations are wrongly assumed to be contraindications for breastfeeding. Women who've had cesarean deliveries. In them, breastfeeding can be initiated in the semi-recumbent position or on sitting up. Women who received vaccinations. Neither inactivated or live vaccines administered to a lactating mother affects the safety of breastfeeding for the mother or the baby. Women who had breast surgery. They need to breastfeed frequently to maintain blood supply. If the surgical wound is painful, the other breast can be used. The baby's growth needs to be monitored to see if there is adequate milk supply to the baby. When the mother has hepatitis A, breastfeeding can be initiated after the baby receives immune serum globulin. The baby has to be vaccinated at 1 year of age. When the mother has hepatitis B, breastfeeding can be initiated after the baby receives hepatitis B immune globulin and the first dose of hepatitis B vaccine series. When the mother has hepatitis C, hepatitis C is not a contraindication for breastfeeding, but if the mother has cracked or bleeding nipples, breastfeeding needs to be reconsidered.